Three Kids. It's Miss Sarah. It's so good to see you. I'm glad that you're here for our lesson today. Let's start out by praying together. Let's close our eyes and bow our heads and talk to God. Dear God, thank you so much for this time that we have to learn from your word. Please teach us what you want us to know and help us to grow in our relationship with you because of the time that we are spending today. In Jesus' name, amen. Enjoy the lesson.
One afternoon, Peter and John, two of Jesus' followers, went to the temple to pray. They saw a man sitting by a gate. The man could not walk. Every day, the man's friends carried him to the temple. As people entered the temple, the man asked them for money since he couldn't work. Peter said to the man, "Look at us." The man looked at Peter and John, expecting them to give him something. Peter said, "I don't have any silver or gold for you, but I will give you what I do have." Then Peter said, "In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, get up and walk." Peter reached out and helped the man up. All of a sudden, the man's feet and ankles were strong. He could walk. In fact, the man leaped around. He went into the temple with Peter and John, and he praised God. The people in the temple saw that the man was healed, and they were amazed. The next day, the religious leaders asked Peter and John, "How did you heal this man? By what power or in what name did you do this?" Peter was filled with the Holy Spirit. He said, "This man was healed by the power of Jesus Christ from Nazareth. You nailed Jesus to a cross, but God raised him from the dead. It is because of him that this man is healed." Peter told the religious leaders that they rejected Jesus because they thought he was not important, but he is the most important one of all. The religious leaders didn't know what to say. They ordered Peter and John to never preach or teach in the name of Jesus again. Peter and John said, "Do you think it would be right for us to listen to you instead of God? We cannot be quiet. We must tell people about what we have seen and heard." Peter and John met with other believers and prayed that God would give them power to speak boldly and without fear. After Jesus returned to heaven, the Holy Spirit gave the disciples power to begin working. With the power of Jesus' name, Peter healed a man who was lame. Not even the religious leaders could stop Jesus' followers from sharing the good news about Jesus.
count of three, when children open their shoe boxes, they're so excited.
I mean, it's just been incredible. Kids are so excited, giving them a gift, do it in Jesus' name, and that's what this is all about.
Jesus loves you.
It's a gospel opportunity. It's the chance for the children to change the entire life.
The word of God is spreading. The gospel is advancing.
It is impacting children. It is impacting families. It is impacting the world greatly.
Thank you for praying. Thank you for giving. God will bless, and God will use your gift to touch the life of a child and to be able to do it in Jesus' name. So thank you. Thank you for being a part of it. God bless each and every one of you.
God's very good idea. In the beginning, in fact, before the beginning, God had a very good idea. It was an even better idea than solar panels, chocolate chip cookies, the Super Soaker, color TV, fireworks, roller skates, the life raft, even the X-ray machine. God's idea was to make people, lots of people, lots of different people who would all enjoy loving him and all enjoy loving each other. They would all be made in his image. They would all be like mirrors reflecting what God is like. Because God is full of love, they would be full of love too. So God got to work. He made a beautiful world for people to live in. Then he made the first people, a man and a woman. And he said to them, "Be happy. Enjoy loving me and loving each other. Have a huge family that will fill the earth and look after the earth and enjoy the earth." God carried on creating people. All of them were made in his image, and all of them were different too. Some were men and some were women. Some liked reading and some liked riding bikes. Some had darker skin and some had lighter skin. Some had curly hair and some had straight hair. We live in God's world. We are all different. But we are also all the same. Everyone you see is different than you, and the same as you. They might look different, or speak different, or play different, but they are all made in God's image, and so they are all valuable. This is God's very good idea. But people ruined God's very good idea. The first people chose not to love God. This is called sin. And because they chose not to love God as they should, they forgot how to love each other as they should. We are the same. We choose not to love God, and so we are not able to love each other like we should. We sin. Sometimes we treat others badly because they are different than us. People fight with each other. People are mean to each other. People laugh at each other. Because we have ruined God's very good idea, he is not pleased with us. Our sin means we can't be friends with him or enjoy living with him. We need God's forgiveness for ruining his very good idea. It's the same for everyone in the world. People who like reading need forgiveness, and people who like riding bikes need forgiveness. People with darker skin need forgiveness, and people with lighter skin need forgiveness. People with curly hair need forgiveness, and people with straight hair need forgiveness. But God was not surprised by people ruining things. He had always had a very good plan to rescue his very good idea. So God got to work. He came to earth as a person, Jesus. Jesus loved people who were different than him. He loved people who no one else loved. He always enjoyed loving all the different people he met. Jesus shows us how to enjoy loving each other. But people didn't love Jesus. Instead, they hated him. They put him on a cross to die. But this was part of God's plan. On the cross, Jesus took our sin so that we can be forgiven. Jesus forgives his people for their sins. Jesus didn't stay dead. He rose back to life and then went back to live in heaven. And then he gave people his spirit to help them enjoy loving him and loving all the different people they know. Jesus helps us to love each other. One day, God will finish his very good idea. Jesus will come back and make the world perfect again. And anyone who has asked Jesus to forgive them will live there, with their different languages and skin colors. They will enjoy loving God and loving each other. They will enjoy praising God for making, rescuing, and finishing his very good idea. But here's a very, very, very good part of God's very good idea. You don't have to wait until then to enjoy it. Jesus welcomes anyone who asks him to forgive them. And when Jesus welcomes someone, he welcomes them into his family forever. He welcomes people who like reading and people who like riding bikes. He welcomes people with darker skin and people with lighter skin. He welcomes people with curly hair and people with straight hair. God's family is called the church. Your church friends are your brothers and sisters, your wonderful and colorful church family. You can enjoy loving them and loving God with them. This is God's very good idea. Lots of different people enjoying loving him and loving each other. God made it. People ruined it. He rescued it. He will finish it. And with your church family, you can enjoy being part of it right now.
Hi there, I'm Pastor Brian, and it's time for Questions from Kids. Eva from Andrews, Texas asks,
I prayed for God to heal my grandmother when she got sick, but he didn't. Why?
Eva, let me say first of all that I'm sorry that your grandmother was sick. I know that is so hard when somebody that you care about is sick and doesn't get well. You know, in today's Bible story, we saw that the Holy Spirit gave Peter power to heal a man, and so your question is natural. Well, if God has the ability to heal somebody and heal anybody, why doesn't he heal everybody? You know, when we think about the Gospels, think about Jesus in the four Gospels, we see him healing many, many different people, don't we? But we don't see him heal everyone. Also in the book of Acts, we see the disciples, like here, where Peter healed somebody through God's power, but they didn't heal everyone as well. So what we can understand is this, that God, yes, he has the power to heal anyone that he wants to heal, but we cannot expect that God will do that. There are times that he will heal, and there are times that he will not. Now again, we don't always understand what God does. It makes sense to us that he would heal everybody. He loves everybody, why not? But we have to trust that everything that God does, or sometimes what he does not do, is for his glory and our good. And so there are times, it's hard to understand why, but we have to trust this, that God will not heal somebody and it's actually gonna bring him glory. We see that a few times in scripture as well. I think of the man born blind in John chapter 9. The Bible says that man was born and lived his whole life without being able to see. And that was hard. We can understand. He would ask, why is God doing this? But then we see how God used him in his blindness to bring himself glory. And so we need to trust the same thing. But here's good news, great news even. There is one way that God will always heal. Always, always, and that is spiritual healing when a person trusts in Jesus. We know that nobody who calls on Jesus, nobody who trusts in Jesus will not go unhealed from his or her sin, that it will always be forgiven. And so that is something we can have great confidence in, and hopefully that gives us great joy. So here's a question back for you. How can God use something sad like sickness for his glory and our good?
Well, that's it for our lesson today. Let's pray together before we end our time. Let's close our eyes and bow our heads and talk to God. Dear God, thank you so much for this lesson. Please help us to remember the things that you want us to know, and to live differently this week because we follow you. In Jesus' name, amen. Have a good week. Thank you.